use or the threat of use of military force against it, as well as for political pressure.
Being prepared may involve being in NATO, but Finland knows that brings risks. A recent report of the Finnish Parliament notes this could lead to increased tension on the border between Finland and Russia and would move the NATO alliance closer to strategically important areas in Russia. And that is an issue for the Russian government. The Kremlin spokesperson Dmitry Peskov says it would have to rebalance the situation with its own measures if Finland and Sweden join. He also warned that further expansion will not bring additional security to the European continent. And Finland is listening to this. Here's the Prime Minister again.
Of course, there are many risks, and we have to be prepared for all kind of actions from Russia. Hybrid threats, cyber attacks, different kind of influencing from Russia's side.
Finland and Sweden also know that if they ask, few expect NATO to say no.
There's a sense that why would you want these two pro-European members of the EU, flourishing democracies, strong armies, outside of NATO if you can have them in? I think there's no real dispute.
All of which means there's a renewed focus on this part of Europe. BBC's John Simpson described it.
This could one day be the border between NATO and Russia. It's the precise opposite of what Russia wanted.
And it's an outcome that could happen within months.
I should imagine that NATO's been flirting with Sweden and Finland for a long time. But I also understand why the likes of Finland and that wouldn't have wanted to be part of NATO until now. Their history.
Just what? Kill him?
Yeah. Well, she can't go home. Imagine Georgia's another country
that's probably
shitting
itself right now too. Georgia? Yeah. Another Russian, ex-Russian. It feels far removed from war-torn Ukraine.
Both Ukrainians fleeing Russian bombs and Russians escaping their own government. These days, just calling Putin's war a war sends Russians to jail. And since his special operation began in February, tens of thousands of Russians have fled here to Georgia, one of the few places they can live without visas.
I hear Georgia about this week somewhere in America.
Yeah, but it's not. It's a country. Well, the one that used to be part of the US as well.
Collecting humanitarian aid for Ukraine, gathering in bookshops selling banned Russian books, or staging protests that would see them beaten and
Yeah.
People's lives, their homes, their families, their future. Of course it is a crime. What else can it be?
Christina left Moscow days after the invasion began, knowing it could be many years before she returns. She's asked us not to say her age or full name for fear of reprisals against her family in Russia.
And I knew that I wouldn't be able to keep silent, and I had a choice. Either I would stay in Russia and go to jail, or I would move to other country and would try to do something to support people in Ukraine and support people in Russia who can't leave for many reasons.
Anton Mikhalchuk works for an organization helping settle the flood of Russians now arriving. He says the Russians here are just one part of an exploding diaspora.
Вообще из России выехало примерно 200,000 человек за этот месяц. Это все тоже эмоции. Я разделяю это на категории эмоциональные иммигранты, кто уехал, испугавшись железного занавеса. Кто-то уехал, потому что понимает, что он больше не может развивать бизнес и работу. Ну и, конечно, очень большой пласт – это активисты, журналисты, правозащитники, которые совершенно понимают, что завтра они могут оказаться в тюрьме. И это количество очень сильно каждый день растет. То есть сейчас даже посчитать невозможно, сколько людей каждый день арестовано.
Vladimir Putin says every single one of them is a traitor.
Yeah.
Any nation, and especially the Russian nation, will always be able to distinguish real patriots from scum.
Yeah.
Just spit them out like an insect that flew into the mouth by accident. Spit onto the footpath. Convinced this natural and necessary self-cleansing of society will only make our country stronger.
While Russians have flooded in since February, Putin has been tightening the noose on opposition for years.
Here is kind of an empty space now.
Nikan Akulchina fled here in July, bringing a fire of hatred for Putin that has only burned brighter with the war.
Oh my god, my country go to the war to Ukraine. And I fucking love Ukraine. And also I fucking love Russia.
Nika is a prominent artist with Pussy Riot.
Pussy Rand.
Right.
Dared to ridicule Putin and all who supported his dictatorship. From the Russian Orthodox Church to police.
Нужно бороться за то, чтобы в России перестали публиковать уголовные дела.
The day of the World Cup final in Moscow, she and three others dressed in police uniforms to invade the field, stopping the match as the president looked on.
So yeah, I decided just to say out loud that fuck the police.
Yeah, and you ran out in the field in front of Putin.
Yeah. Hope so. Hope he was crying.
But that made you a target.
Yes, but it's not a problem for me because I cannot imagine how could I like live in Russia and be silent.
In court, she was defiant. She kept smiling even after she was sentenced to 15 days of detention.
I thought he was going to say 15 years or 15 days. Of course, she's fucking smiling. Just don't have to get food this next week. Oh, what was that for?
Oh, she just kept protesting off the jail.
Well, serve her right. Become a bug.
I think we need to wait for his death.
Which could be years.
Which could be years.
When Nika and her friends were first jailed, other members of Pussy Riot made this
Pussy Riot.
Yeah, that's what they called themselves.
No pussy right for you.
Sasha Sofeyev joined Nika in Tbilisi.
So, have you left Russia for forever? Or what? What's your plan?
Of course not. When I left, I hoped to return as soon as possible, but as we see months go by and the situation gets catastrophically worse. I can't go back now, it's not safe for me.
Putin's invasion of Ukraine has been accompanied by a vicious crackdown inside Russia. Since February, the last vestiges of democracy have been stamped out with brute force.
Brute.
Oh yeah, they're beating that one. Kicks in the face. Mm-mm. Then the cameraman got set upon for recording it.
Black sheets of paper.
Blank. There's nothing on and they're just holding them up to the camera and they're being arrested for it.
Yelena Osipova is 76.
Oh, they even arrested her.
Yep.
She continues to brave arrest.
I'm not afraid of anything anymore. Why should I be afraid?
Yeah, I'm fucking gangster.
Been participating in protests since 2002.
She lives in St. Petersburg, this small filled with her other passion, painting. She has put that skill to work creating anti-war posters. Police keep confiscating them.
My first time my posters were stolen by the police. I was so upset. People told me don't be upset. They are good Russians too, but now there is so much shame for our country.
Yelena was born in the aftermath of the siege of Leningrad, when Nazis blockaded St. Petersburg, starving nearly a million people. Has tried to emulate this mythology, claiming absurdly that Ukraine is run by Nazis. Yelena will have none of it.
This is all made up. Such nonsense. This was cultivated during recent years by the authorities. Very few people remember the war. Those who do remember have lived through it.
And them saying these dead. Things.
Yelena's age gives her some leeway to speak out. Police are less likely to jail or beat her.
No, they're not.
Vulnerable to ordinary Russians who see her as a traitor.
If you're proud of this country, don't sit here with all of this. The rich Russian woman think that she's being paid to protest.
Yeah.
Actually having a pop at her. No shame, just like how brainwashed they are.
Thank you.
MPs legislated in jail terms for basically what they class as bad propaganda, fake news, any journalist telling the truth.
Get humped.
Tatiana has put her life on the line before. In 2017, a crazed nationalist broke into her studio and stabbed her. She nearly bled to death. Weeks later, she was back on it. Now she's not sure how much longer she can keep going.
I don't know if I could be that kind of brave. Where you going? Can't let you off. There's one on top here for me. No.
Buttons, boss.